looking too goddamn hot.
That's what it was.
Because,
yes.
I mean, I'm sorry. Dress her up in a fucking muumuu or cast somebody else who just isn't fucking pretty, you know?
Have her wake up with some rollers in her hair or something, you know?
I was laughing about how at the beginning of the movie, like, she's about to run out of time herself. And nobody wants to help this chick. As soon as a guy, like, as soon as somebody sees her, it's like she's the walking fucking dead. People start running in their fucking houses, start slamming the door on her. A truck driver comes by. She's waving her hands. And this motherfucker don't even stop for Olivia Wilde,
man. It's like
a truck driver?
Really? Yeah, I'm like, come on. Yeah, you know, okay, I'm sorry. That's the most unbelievable thing in the movie.
I said, film, you lost me.
Yeah, I'm that. From there, you jump whatever time shark is in this movie. But the other person I found convincing, as far as just seeming somebody who was a little wise and a little older, was Vincent Cathesa. That guy, I don't know what it was about him. Maybe it was acting that was better than everybody else. I don't know. But maybe, you know, in the movie, he's supposed to be somebody who's 80 years old. And I'm like, okay, maybe I don't buy 80, but I do buy you as being older than everybody else in this world. And I'm a little bit convinced. Or maybe it's just the way he looked. For some reason, they had his ass looking old. Because if you notice, his lips were red through the whole movie.
Yeah.
And he looked like, tell me if you didn't think this. Like, if you drew two lines down the side of his lips, down past his jaw, tell me he wouldn't look like a ventriloquist dummy.
Oh, he would. Yeah, you're absolutely right.
His ass looking like Charlie McCartney in this movie. Or something, you know?
Maybe if they had him go, let me tell you a story.
Maybe people's vocal cords aged in this movie or something. That could be more. But I did like him in the film. Now, there's some things that I did like about the film that not enough to make it a good movie, but they had some ideas that worked for brief moments. Again, going back to this character of Philip Weiss, there's a point in the movie where I like what they did with the concept. He was talking about, I know you're sitting here with me and you're looking at this girl over here who's associated with me, and you're probably wondering, okay, is this my daughter? Is this my sister? Is this my wife? Is this my cousin? You know, is this my auntie? And he's like, and he says,
is my dog.
My dog, dogs even look pretty. Yeah. And so he was like, hey, it used to be a much simpler time, didn't it, when those lines were well-defined. Now today it's a little more confusing. And I was like, yeah, you goddamn right it is, you know? I was like, everybody be fucking everybody in this future.
Confusing times. Is she my mother, my sister, my daughter? You're hoping she's not my wife. Things used to be simpler once, so I'm told. Very beautiful. Daughter. She does look a lot like my wife. Sylvia. Will Salas.
Congratulations, Mr. Salas. You've taken years off my father's life.
Which is normally what you do. Isn't that right, my darling?
We're having a party tomorrow night. Perhaps you'll give him a chance to win back some of those years.
I'd love to.
And I like that concept right there. And another thing that I like is that they did have about two or three moments where you felt time running down on people. It's like I didn't find it convincing in the story itself, but for certain scenes when people had to get, they had like their life was ticking away. Mm-hmm. And there was just a small sense of suspense there for me.
Really?
Yeah. Like I said, brief moments. It wasn't enough to carry the movie. That's what I was disappointed about. I was like, I think there's areas they could have developed and ideas they could have elaborated on that would have made this concept a lot better if they had just thought it through in a better story. And I think there's some good ideas here because the director put some of these ideas similar to something like this to use in another film, which explains why the movie's so clean looking too. We were talking about this. Andrew Niccol did Gattaca.
Right.
And that was another sci-fi film that was kind of light on the sci-fi appearance. It kind of resembled more a very sterilized version of our world, but that story was a little bit better.
It was way better.
Yeah, it looked like it had more budget to it.
Better executed. I mean, it's like leaps and bounds better than this. I couldn't buy any of the suspense dealing with the time, only because I thought it was dealt with so poorly. And when people fucking died, I mean, it was about the equivalent of seeing Mr. Hankey die, where it's just like, it's like somebody like shoving a finger up your asshole and you go, and then you're dead. I mean, it was so quick and so just, it felt to me like, wow, this is something they teach you not to do when you die in acting class.
Well, that was funny.
I could not buy it.
When you die in this movie, not only do you like that old cliche thing of, But your ass goes out like Michael Jackson. You flip your head back. You stand on those toes. You throw your arms up in the air. And I think you even throw out like a little. And then your ass falls over. And that's funny because in all these streets, in this very clean, sterilized ghetto, not a piece of paper or anything littered on the floor, but there's pretty dead bodies everywhere. Nobody bothered to pick up whatsoever.
No, I'm like, dude, they must have a fucking guy with a wheelbarrow going up. I'm here to pick up your dad. Bring out your dad.
Yeah. God damn, where's Woodsy Allen in this world? Yeah. God damn, somebody give a hoot.
I know.
Don't pollute with all these dead pretty bodies everywhere, yeah. You know?
It's like, is that Joe?
Yeah.
I guess I'm going to have to take care of and share the work today.
Yeah, I guess everybody's just like, that dead body? Man, I got about 2 hours left of my life. I got to go to work. Shit. Better him than me. Fuck. But yeah, you know, man.
I know what you're probably going to say, and I can't wait to hear it. I think I'm going probably, and I'm just going to be safe, and you tell me.
Okay.
I'm going to be a little softer on this movie because I like, like I said, there's a few hints of things that I like. But the movie is a low rental. For a movie like this, where it's all about people rushing because they're running out of time, those people who are living the world of this movie, I would say go see this movie because this movie drags out its time so much. It just suffers from being dull. Mm-hmm. It's a boring film with an interesting concept, and that's the biggest crime that this movie commits. So yeah, I'm giving this like a very low rental.
Oh, man. Okay. Well, you said it. It is fucking boring. And anything that bores me to death, especially with a sci-fi type concept of like this, I mean, fuck. You know, take some more time on that goddamn script. Develop your characters. Give me a reason to give a shit. Give me a reason to care about this guy's motivation to all of a sudden want to do what he wants to do. And what makes you so fucking special that this didn't happen to anybody else to give them the same motivation that you're having right now?
Yeah.
After all these fucking
years. Talking about for Justin Timberlake.
Yeah, Justin Timberlake's character. I just could not buy it. You know, with a movie like this, especially with its concept where it could be easily laughable, which in this case it is. I look at a movie like Equilibrium mm-hmm. that did it so right, where they had the sterile look. They had a guy who all of a sudden he had a change in him, in his character, to motivate him to do something about the society he was living in, and it fucking worked because you know what, they had fucking gun kata, and this they don't got none of that shit.
They ain't got time for none of that.
What do they do, they smug at the camera, look at each other with dreamy eyes half the time, and you got Cillian Murphy running around trying to chase fucking somebody who's never there. I just could not buy it, and yeah, it was slow, it fucking dragged, and you know what, this would have worked better as a short film, and I'm talking about a 5-10 minute short film, and that is fucking it. And be done with the premise and do something worth the shit. I mean, this director wasted my fucking time, and that is the biggest crime, all right? So, yeah, learn how to manage your time better, all right? So,
learn how to manage your time better.
This is some old bullshit, yes.
Wow.
Some deep old bullshit.
Some deep bullshit, like you knee deep in that bullshit. Hey, you know what, man? Look, I do understand because I'm almost there with you. I'm right mm-hmm. behind you. That whole thing you said about Olivia Wilde, man, there's a scene in the movie where they got me. First of all, speaking of Olivia Wilde and Justin Timberlake, I hate to say this. Mm-hmm. I hate to say this, but if it was a world like this where everybody was this pretty and my mom looks like something like Olivia Wilde, mm-hmm. all the women in my life look like that, mm-hmm. I'm sorry, I'd be fucking sisters, my mom, my aunt, I'd be, you know, shit, I'd be fucking everybody in my family. We'd be the most retarded family on the block, because I wouldn't care. I'm sorry, everybody's pretty.
your family reunion would look like an Aphex Twin video.
Yeah. Our family reunion would look like the Austin State School. and then my family would look like Arkham Asylum up in there. And then this whole thing, there's a scene in this movie, man, I just got to illustrate. I don't want to spoil anybody on this movie, but I got to tell you something. Mm-hmm. There's a scene where Olivia Wilde has to meet her son, Justin Timberlake, in the movie, because mm-hmm. she has a birthday party that she wants to celebrate. Now, in the movie, she has 2 hours left, an hour and a half. Mm-hmm. An hour and a half left in her time. Now, why they decided not to meet 5 minutes away from the house where they can save that time, or better yet, like get some takeout so it can mm-hmm. be brought to the house and they ain't got to waste no time going away? I don't know. But for some reason, they wanted to be special. I think because he went all this time, he could pay for it and everything. Mm-hmm. He'd give us some money. Okay, I'll let that slide. But she goes to a bus, and she tells the bus driver, okay, I need to get to like the other end of town. And the guy's like, okay, that's going to be 2 hours. She looks at our arm and she's like, damn, I only have an hour and a half.
That's a 2-hour walk to where I need to go. And that bus driver said, well, bitch, you better start running. and she runs to the point where she's getting down to like, I guess she ran the whole time, but she never broke a sweat.
Not at all.
I guess you stopped sweating after 25 too. But she's down to like around like about 10 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
It's obvious what's going to happen. But I'm thinking to myself, okay, I'm running. My life is ticking away before my eyes. Mm-hmm. I'm a hot chick. I don't want to be sexist to anybody. But you better believe I'm selling some ass on the way. On the way. That's why I couldn't believe guys running the house from her. Because if she had just flung them breasts out, flung them titties out, started running towards the guy. God, give me some time. Ask for time. You better believe.
She's Olivia Wilde. But hey, you know what? I guess that bus driver was burned by Tron. I guess that's one motherfucker.
I saw the movie.
Like that movie. I'm sorry. You didn't impress me. You fucked up an instant classic.
I'm telling you people, if you think I'm being sexist, if I was her and I saw my time slipping away like that and I'm running down the street, you better believe I'm sucking dick before I get to where I got to go. I'm like a crackhead. I suck your dick.
You be sucking that time out of that dick.
Oh, yeah. This system doesn't. Yeah, I'll be sucking that. I'll be sucking that arm. I'm telling you, man, the system does not work. This world will be full of like mongoloids and venereal diseases. For people trying to get that time and fucking their relatives.
Please take me home.
Can't do that.
Why?
You're keeping me alive. Yeah, this is my intention.